The U.S. Navy, as per the budget proposal for 2022, plans to install a dozen or so conventional prompt strike, or CPS, missiles on each of these Zumwalt-class warships. The U.S. Navy is requesting Congress for $1.4 billion in 2022 in order to continue developing the CPS missile and begin installing it to the Zumwalts. Viewers may note that the service previously announced it would fit the 35-inch diameter, two-stage missile in multi-purpose launch tubes that it's installing on the new Block 5 version of the Virginia-class submarine. The aim is to provide the Zumwalt-class warships a serious land attack capability. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. Navy plans to bring out beast mode in Zumwalt-class warships with the installation of conventional prompt strike hypersonic missile. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Zumwalt-class destroyer is designed as multi-mission stealth ships with a focus on land attack. It brings stealth to a major warship. Zumwalt-class destroyers feature unique, wave-piercing, tumble-home hulls. The hull slopes inward from above the waterline, which is very different from traditional hulls, which move outwards at a hard angle. The design significantly reduces the radar cross-section, since the slope makes the hull return very less radar signal that's directed to it when compared to a traditional hull. Some reports indicate that the ship has a radar return similar to a small fishing boat. There's no other frontline battleship that has this kind of revolutionary design. The Zumwalt-class destroyers have two 155mm guns, as well as 80 Mark 57 cells protected by the Peripheral Vertical Launch System, PVLS. The PVLS is designed to reduce the chances of the risk of loss of the entire missile battery, or even the entire ship in case of the magazine explosion, and are placed in the outer shell of the ship's superstructure. Each Mark 57 can carry a single SM-2 or SM-6 long-range surface-to-air missile, ASROC anti-submarine rocket torpedo, or up to 4 evolved Sea Sparrow short-range surface-to-air missiles. Importantly, they can also carry Tomahawks. Conventional Prompt Strike, CPS, is a United States military effort to develop a system that can deliver a precision conventional strike in a similar manner to a nuclear ICBM. Such a weapon would allow the United States to respond far more swiftly to rapidly emerging threats than is possible with conventional forces. CPS will have hypersonic speed. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed the speeds of Mach 5, that is, 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. CPS is intended to complement existing American rapid response forces, such as forward deployed forces, air expeditionary groups, which can deploy within 48 hours, and carrier battle groups, which can respond within 96 hours. It will be an alternative to nuclear weapons for strategic retaliatory strikes for around 30% of targets. CPS was originally designed to deploy aboard U.S. Navy submarines, but they're now in line to be deployed to the Zumwalt warships as well as several other platforms. Conventional prompt strike missile has a larger footprint when compared to many other ship-based missiles. To accommodate the first stage booster and the second stage container for the hypersonic glide vehicle, it will have a length of 40 feet. The booster is responsible for propelling the glider to hypersonic speed. CPS won't fit in the Mark 57 cell of the Zumwalt class. While the Zumwalts are pretty large vessels, displacing 16,000 tons of water, which is nearly twice that of Arleigh Burke-class destroyers, it doesn't have much space. This is mainly because of the downward sloping hulls, which limit the scope. To mitigate this, the U.S. Navy plans to remove the two 155mm advanced gun systems presently sitting on the bow of each Zumwalt. Zumwalt was supposed to get close to the enemy using its stealth design and use the gun system to hurl projectiles from a range of 80 miles or around 130 kilometers, but this didn't work out. The long-range land attack projectile, or LRLAP, the precision-guided shell that would arm the ship's guns, saw cost escalation from $50,000 a round to $800,000. Which is equivalent to cruise missiles that have much longer range and hence not practical. So LRLAP was canceled and the guns are currently useless. The space made available with the removal of the advanced gun system should enable the Zumwalt to accommodate a dozen CPS missiles. Zumwalt class has been an expensive, very long and torturous undertaking. But the class is one of a kind and has a lot of potentials. Zumwalt's stealth characteristics will enable it to sneak in undetected near the target, and a CPS hypersonic missile launched from the relatively close range will be nearly impossible to stop. The three Zumwalt warships could be assigned to target high-value enemy assets, which might be a suicide mission for conventional surface vessels. The Zumwalt has been plagued with development and construction issues, but the addition of CPS could be a genuine redemption. Missile defense is incredibly complex and expensive to develop, and even more pricey to operationally deploy. It requires detection as well as interception systems to work perfectly in tandem. So it's being pursued by only a few nations. Hypersonic missile interception will be even harder to pull off as the missile defense system will have very little time to analyze and intervene. It can be said that the Zumwalt class, armed with CPS missiles, will be as potent as it gets.